At 5:30, an historical marker unveiled, celebrating the accomplishments of Huntington's codebreaker, cryptoanalyst Elizebeth Smith Friedman, honored for her efforts during both world wars and Prohibition II.
It's an incredible story with strong roots out in 21 Country. We'll have more on that event here soon.
But first, who was Elizabeth and her husband William? There is no better person to tell us than the man who called them Grandma and Grandpa.
We have my grandmother, and I'm presuming that's my mother, or it actually looks like Uncle John, I'll tell you.
Chris Atchison spent several years living with Elizabeth and William Friedman in Washington, D.C.
And I love her coat there.
Much of the world didn't know it then, but they were American heroes.
Ha ha! There's me.
To him, they were just Grandma and Grandpa.
My grandfather working for the Army, my grandmother basically working for the Navy, right? They weren't allowed to talk about work, which is bizarre.
As Chris would learn later in life, the Friedmans were code breakers, employed by the government to decipher hidden messages and intercepted enemy plans.
We had no code breaking whatsoever, basically after the Civil War.
After college, Elizabeth left Huntington for Riverbank Laboratories in Illinois, where she would meet her future husband.
She draws my grandfather into cryptology and code breaking. He becomes the preeminent code breaker in America, breaks the Japanese purple code for the Pacific Theater in World War II. That changes the outcome of that war, period, end of story.
Though it was Elizabeth, perhaps even more so, who knew if there were secrets to be found, how to find them. And despite the expectations of women during that era, she provided invaluable help against opposition in both world wars, including decrypting radio messages from the Nazis and then organized crime during Prohibition.
My grandmother's still doing the job with the Navy, breaking codes, breaking Enigma, the cipher machine, and taking care of the home, and taking care of my mother, and taking care of my Uncle John, and taking care of my grandfather, and doing all of this.
Only recently have documents of her work been uncovered, revealing just how vital Elizabeth Smith Friedman's legacy was to our country.
It's my assertion that without my grandmother, this is a different world that we're gonna live in. A little farm girl from Indiana who goes out, and pardon me, goes out and kicks and, you know, beats Nazis with a paper and a pencil. And I think that's an important story for young women and young men to understand that, you know, you don't have to come from anywhere in particular, that you can go out and do great things.
That may be the first time we've ever bleeped anything in 21 Country. There you go. Well, Chris traveled from out of state to be in Huntington today, where Elizabeth's other relatives are. A public dedication ceremony, which just wrapped up, was held for the county's 13th historical marker. Elizabeth Smith Friedman's marker can be found at Memorial Park. The plaque shares a couple of accomplishments, which also include teaching military officers how to break codes and helping the Coast Guard catch rum runners and drug smugglers. We spoke to family members who were there and Mayor Richard Strick.
Folks from a small city like Huntington, Indiana can make a global difference the way that she did. And ultimately, the intersection of her passions and talents that she honed over the years, meeting the world's problems, made a huge difference. And I hope that it's an inspiration for all of our residents, but in particularly for young women to be involved with engineering and mathematics and the hard sciences, because she demonstrates that no matter what era, if you've got the talent, you can make a difference.
In the last 5 years, several books and a PBS documentary have detailed the Friedman story. Chris says as a child, he remembers walks to the White House and his grandparents meeting with congressmen and generals. Elizabeth would give him coded birthday and Christmas cards. His full interview and more on our website right now, WPTA21.com.